This is the Earth. Okay, lesson over. Just kidding. You're going to render your own map in your site in just a moment. Google Maps are made up of lots of different types of data. Imagery, road networks, points of interest, more things. You'll use pieces and combinations of that data to build a user experience that has value. When you render a map, you can control what type of information you get. One of the most basic things you can control when you render your map is the map type. We have four pre-configured map types. You're probably most familiar with the roadmap map type, which you've seen as the default in Google Maps. We also have satellite, if you want real images of the world, or hybrid, in which we overlay features such as roads on top of satellite imagery. And finally, we have terrain, which emphasizes shaded relief and other physical terrain information. Now that you understand what you're seeing, let's load the map into your site.
I'm starting off with just a basic HTML site. It's blank right now. You can load a Google map into your site simply by adding three things into your code. The first is a script line into your HTML to load the API. This loads the JavaScript definitions when the page starts loading in the browser. We're loading the JavaScript here asynchronously, which means the rest of the page will render while the JavaScript API loads, and then our callback function will execute when the API is done loading. If you're not immediately using the API's functionality, you can put the same instruction inside a function and call it only when you plan to use it. Loading the API asynchronously gives you more speed as it lets your page load without having to wait for the JavaScript. Maps.googleapis.com is the endpoint that we're loading the JavaScript from. The parameter v equals 3 indicates that we're calling version 3 of the API, which is the version that we want to use. Next, you must include the API key that you just created. Use the key parameter and simply paste in the browser key that you generated in your project. Alternatively, you can use a client ID if you're a Maps API's premium plan customer. We'll learn more about that later in the course. The next thing that you need is a div element in your HTML body with the ID of map. Easy. I'm also adding some CSS to specify that I want our map to be 100% of the height of the page. Finally, we'll need some more JavaScript, a map variable, and an initialize JavaScript function to load the map. Something to note, I'm putting all of this in one file, but you can also separate out your JavaScript into a separate file to keep it neat. This initialize function will contain everything that will happen after the page loads, but before the user interacts with the map. For now, its only job is to make a map appear. We're creating a new map instance here, and we must specify two things. Where in the HTML to load the map, which is going to be that map div that we created, and what part of the world to show. We have to give it a center and a zoom value so that it knows what imagery to show and in how much detail. The center is a latitude and longitude in the form of what's called a lat-long literal. We'll use this all the time throughout the course. The zoom is just a number. The higher the number, the more detail. You can go up to level 21. All right, you've made a beautiful dynamic map of your very own. This map is centered on the lovely Google office in New York City. Notice that all classes live within the Google.maps namespace. We just saw an example of this when we used the Google.maps.map class to create a map object. As you learn more about the classes, you'll see this naming convention over and over. Now, you try.